Boy, it's rough to see those images down there.
It really is.
It is. Mm-hmm. I mean, it's hard to even comprehend that much water.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And to put in perspective for us, day one of the flood, we had about 6 to 7 inches of rain.
Yeah.
Then there was another 6 to 7 inches of rain on day two. So you're talking 13 inches for the whole weekend in the metro area. And you've got some of those places there that have 20, 25. And some places could end up with between 40 and 50 inches of rain.
50 inches is possible. That's crazy.
It really is. And what else I heard this morning, too, was that they had tornado warnings and watches out.
Yeah.
So you have people on their roofs.
Yeah.
You know, trying to get away from the high water, and then they were having to weather the tornado warnings.
The tornado warnings, and you know, that's usually when these systems come on board and come on land, they usually have a ton of water with them. But the danger also, especially on coastal areas, they have that capability of producing tornado warnings. So I know there have been well over 100, 120 tornado warnings in the greater Texas area since this thing came on shore.
Incredible.
Gee whiz.
So for us, we'll keep an eye on it. It's still, the problem is going to drift. And we talked about this last week. It wasn't the wind that was going to be the big issue. It was the fact that this thing was going to produce a lot of rain down that way. And this thing is going to slowly drift toward Arkansas by the end of the week, just barely into Arkansas. So here we go with what's happening right now. For today, mostly cloudy for you this morning. At noontime, right around 80. At 3 p.m., look for right around 83. From Columbia now, we've got a reading of 73 degrees, mainly cloudy. The key thing now for you here in the Mid-South today, take the umbrella. You may need the umbrella at times today with some scattered showers moving across Middle Tennessee. So here we go in the Music City right now. It is 72. Relative humidity is at 84%, and a wind now coming in out of the south at about 3. 91 and 60, the high and the low for yesterday. So for this morning, here's a look at the cloud cover that we've got in place to begin our day. Not sure if all of this is hitting the ground, but yeah, there are some scattered showers that we'll be dealing with around the Mid-South today. Meanwhile, as we keep an eye on what's happening with Harvey, it's still at tropical storm status. So when winds are 39 or above, it's still tropical storm. And as we talked again, it's not really the winds, it's the rain. And the problem for Houston over the weekend was, even though the center was still west of Houston, this line of rain that we are seeing right now come in on the Texas-Louisiana line, it was that line that fed the Houston area. So Houston has some showers right now, but not the heaviest of the rain. At the moment, we see it right in through here. This is also where there is the risk of tornadoes as they continue right now with that tornado watch for parts of Texas and for the Louisiana area. As we bring you back here into the mid-state today, look for a mostly cloudy sky, scattered showers around the area. There's a slight thunderstorm chance, but overall, scattered showers developing over the Mid-South for us today. Overnight tonight, we'll keep in that rain chance. It's one of those periods where the weather is unsettled, so it's not an all-day, non-stop rain, not an all-night rain, but the chances will be there off and on for rain today, tonight, and for tomorrow. So in the morning, maybe a tad more sunlight out there, but still the chance for a few showers, and temperatures tomorrow warming up into the mid-80s after being in the lower 80s for a lot of you today. So for this afternoon, we're going to make our high right up to around 83. Overnight tonight down to 65, and then for tomorrow, 84. Mainly rain today, but will not rule out a stray thunderstorm tomorrow. Area showers as we look for a high right around 84. And then into Wednesday, 86 degrees. Here is that period of rain now continuing for several days, and we'll see how much more of that rain may be impacted by Harvey as it drifts into Arkansas by the end of the week. Right now, the time is 4:18. Let's head back over to the news desk.